It takes courage and strength to be empathetic. And I'm very proudly an empathetic, compassionately driven politician. I've made a very deliberate decision that in the Westminster style of politics that we have in New Zealand, which is very adversarial, that there is a place for us to still push back a little bit on that. I've always said that it takes courage and strength to be empathetic. And I'm very proudly an empathetic, compassionately driven politician. We teach kindness and empathy and compassion to our children, but then we somehow, when it comes to political leadership, want a complete absence of that. So I am trying to chart a different path that will attract critics, but I can only be true to myself in the form of leadership that I believe in. So now it's a global market, and with that comes, I think, a little bit of fear of job security, fear around whether or not your children will have the same opportunities that you had. And so our response as political leaders can either be twofold. We can capitalise on that fear by blaming others and saying that the answer is to become more and more insular, to become protectionist, to build up those walls around us so that we can retreat back to yesteryear. The alternative for us is actually to give a message of hope, so that actually we can provide for our domestic constituencies. You can expect to have decent healthcare, decent education and a roof over your head. And we can provide that job security if we plan for the future and if we choose not to blame. And so I put myself firmly in that constituency. We have a responsibility as politicians in the language that we use, but also the policies that we provide and the hope that we deliver.